हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, लेक्चर 12। इन लेक्चर 12 वील डिस्कस लॉन्च ऑफ सॉल्ट मार्च बाय महात्मा गांधी। दैट वाज द बिगनिंग ऑफ सिविल डिसोबीडियंस मूवमेंट एंड इन इट्स बैकग्राउंड दैट व्हाई सॉल्ट, व्हाट वाज देयर इन द सॉल्ट, दैट गांधी जी चूज सॉल्ट एज अ सिंबल ऑफ नेशनल स्ट्रगल मूवमेंट against British, then launch of civil disobedience movement, various methods in civil disobedience movement, various activities, and Gandhi-Irwin Pact of 1931. In this video, we will discuss these three points. So let us discuss about the start of सॉल्ट मार्च और दी दांडी मार्च। महात्मा गांधी फाउंड इन सॉल्ट अ पावरफुल सिंबल दैट कुड यूनाइट नेशन। ऑन 31 जनवरी 1930 महात्मा गांधी रोट ए लेटर टू लॉर्ड इरविन, ही वॉज द वॉयसराय ऑफ इंडिया एट दैट टाइम। And in that letter, 11 demands were asked. These demands were common, including the removal of crop tax, revenue, salt tax, and better wages for cotton mill workers or workers in any other mills. So these were the demands. Not only this, Mahatma Gandhi also mentioned that if these demands are not agreed upon, then there would be a nationwide civil disobedience movement. Meaning of civil disobedience movement is to break British laws. In non-cooperation movement, laws were not broken. But now Gandhiji decided to break British laws. That is civil disobedience movement. But Lord Irwin rejected the letter which was sent by Mahatma Gandhi. Then Mahatma Gandhi started his famous Salt March along with his 78 trusted volunteers. The march was over 240 miles from Gandhi Ashram in Sabarmati to coastal town Dandi in Gujarat. Thousands of people came to hear Mahatma Gandhi on the way and they participated in this march. And Gandhiji explained, whosoever came to listen to him, about the meaning of Swaraj and how to achieve it. And after traveling 240 mile distance, that is 10 miles a day, after 24 days journey, on April 6, Mahatma Gandhi and many other thousand people reached Dandi, the coastal town, where salt was prepared ceremonially by boiling sea water. And this salt was sold throughout India. At other places also people prepared salt when they heard about Salt March. Here I would like to remind you again, what was the salt law? According to British salt law, no Indian company or Indian was allowed to prepare salt and sell it. So by preparing salt and selling it, and it was not sold simply, it was sold in front of British buildings, in front of British offices, and thousands of people gave their arrest. And this marked the beginning of civil disobedience movement. Now, Gandhiji suggested what to do in civil disobedience movement. So this can be explained in 5-6 points. पॉइंट नंबर वन, बाय ब्रेकिंग द सॉल्ट लॉ द फेमस सिविल डिसोबीडियंस मूवमेंट वॉज लॉन्च्ड एंड गांधी जी सजेस्टेड टू द पीपल द फॉलोइंग एक्टिविटीज टू बी टेकन अंडर CDM. नाउ पीपल वर आस्क्ड नॉट ओनली टू रिफ्यूज कोऑपरेशन विद द ब्रिटिश बट ऑल्सो ब्रेक कॉलोनियल लॉज. सेकेंड, एज द मूवमेंट स्प्रेड फॉरेन क्लॉथ वॉज बॉयकॉटेड, लिकर शॉप्स वर पिकेटेड, एंट्री इन टू लिकर शॉप्स वॉज ब्लॉक्ड, पीजेंट्स फार्मर्स रिफ्यूज टू पे रेवेन्यू एंड चौकीदारी टैक्सेस, विलेज ऑफिशियल रिजाइंड एट मैनी प्लेसेस, फॉरेस्ट पीपल वॉयलेटेड फॉरेस्ट लॉज बाई एंटरिंग इन टू रिजर्व फॉरेस्ट. एज फॉर फॉरेस्ट लॉज पीपल वर नॉट अलाउड टू एंटर इन टू रिजर्व फॉरेस्ट, दे वर नॉट अलाउड टू टेक देयर कैटल फॉर ग्रेजिंग, दे वर नॉट अलाउड टू कलेक्ट एनी काइंड ऑफ फॉरेस्ट प्रोड्यूस फ्रॉम द रिजर्व फॉरेस्ट. सो सच रेस्ट्रिक्शंस वर वॉयलेटेड एंड पीपल एंटर्ड इन टू रिजर्व फॉरेस्ट. नाउ वरीड बाई दीज डेवलपमेंट्स कॉलोनियल गवर्नमेंट बिगेन अरेस्टिंग लीडर्स. अब्दुल गफ्फार खान, हु इज पॉपुलरली नोन एज फ्रंटियर गांधी, वॉज अ लीडिंग सत्याग्रह मूवमेंट इन पेशावर एंड ही वॉज अ डिवाउट डिसिपल ऑफ महात्मा गांधी, एंड गांधी जी वॉज ऑल्सो अरेस्टेड एज अ पार्ट ऑफ सिविल डिसोबीडियंस मूवमेंट. आफ्टर गांधी जीज अरेस्ट, वर्कर्स इन महाराष्ट्र अटैक्ड ऑन पुलिस पोस्ट, ऑन म्युनिसिपल बिल्डिंग्स, ऑन लॉ कोर्ट्स एंड रेलवे स्टेशंस. एज अ रिजल्ट ब्रिटिश पुलिस स्टार्टेड टॉर्चरिंग चिल्ड्रन विमेन एंड ब्रूटली बीटन द सत्याग्रही. इन सच अ सिचुएशन व्हेन गांधी जी सॉ that British police is taking violent action on satyagrahis and common people, so Gandhiji decided to call off civil disobedience movement and entered into an agreement with Irwin on March 5, 1931, popularly known as Gandhi-Irwin Pact, and went to London to attend second round table conference which was planned to be held in December 1931. First round table conference was already boycotted as a procedure of boycott process. So this was about the civil disobedience movement. Now Gandhi Irwin pact was signed in March 1931. So what were the provisions of Gandhi-Irwin Pact? What agreements, what conditions were put? As per Gandhi-Irwin Pact, Mahatma Gandhi decided to call off civil disobedience movement and agreed to attend second round table conference at Birmingham Palace, London. On the other hand, Irwin agreed to release all arrested leaders and not to arrest any more leaders. But once Gandhiji, along with Muhammad Ali Jinnah, Dr. B.R. Ambedkar and other dignitaries, they reached to London and they came back empty-handed. No demand of Gandhiji was agreed in the second round table conference. And on the other side, Irwin, who promised to release Congress leaders who were already arrested and satyagrahis, and not to arrest many others, not a single satyagrahi or arrested leader was released, and more leaders were picked up. So this is about in this lecture. I hope it will help you to prepare for your examination. Thank you very much.